It's now the middle of spring in coastal British Columbia. The dandelions are out in full force and a great time to go harvest.
So here we are on the roadside. As you can see, there's lots of dandelions out. In early spring, you know, there's a point to be made about not harvesting them because they're one of the first flowers out for bees. And so I do think there's a time of year where it's better to leave them out for a bit. But often with dandelions too, towards middle of spring, there's lots of other flowers and people are starting to mow them out of yards. So if you've got some yards in your neighborhood that are going to be chopping out those dandelions, why not get to work? I would recommend, if you are thinking of foraging with your kids, we kept aside one of the Easter baskets from the Easter egg hunt back in early April, and it turned out to be a great addition. It was easy for Maya to carry, and I don't know if it's safety-wise. It's great to have it on her neck, but it was fine. So basically, I chose a stretch of road where we had nice, quiet traffic and kind of just let Maya go along and pick as we went. There was lots out, and so we just sort of picked a few at a time, and she sort of had a good sense of just picking enough to still leave lots out for some of the other animals that are after the pollen. It was really fun. We spent, I don't know, maybe about an hour just walking along the road. Obviously, practice good road safety. So you also have two options when you're harvesting dandelions. If you want a true bright yellow, you want to dye with just the flower heads. I have dyed dandelions using the flowers and the leaves, but I find out it turns a bit of a greener shade of yellow. So in the end, we got about a pound or a couple pounds worth of dandelions, and we were ready to then head back home and start the dye process.
The first thing we're going to do, Maya, here, is we're going to weigh it. We're going to see how much dandelions we have. So are you going to put it on the scale for me?
Now, I've been experimenting with natural dyeing for about 20 years, and I can tell you that when it comes to plants, dyeing with flowers, roots, bark, leaves, you want a 10-to-1 ratio to start off with. So 10 times as much plant matter to fiber. So if you have 1 pound of fiber you want to dye, try getting 10 pounds of the fresh. And that's what we did with the flowers. We've got about 500 grams of flowers, so 50 grams of yarn. The next step is chopping up your plant matter. And I always recommend this step. I find when you're dyeing with flowers or leaves or bark or even roots, you want to get access to that interior, all those components within the compound structures.
Big one.
That was a pretty big one.
Do a giant one, okay? That's
not
that big.
So Maya, what are we dyeing with today? What are these?
Dandelions.
Dandelions. There we go.
Big one. Do this one.
Okay.
Do this one.
One of the big questions is, how stable will this dye be? How color fast? And dandelions are in the flavonoid group, which are not the most stable of dyers. And really any yellow colors are not that stable, which is why medieval tapestries tend to look so cold and blue these days, is because they've lost that yellow. So I wouldn't, I wouldn't use this for a dye material and then sell that at, let's say, a craft market, but it is great for children because it's so readily available. Okay, so what have we done so far, Maya? We have collected our daffodils, and then did we chop them up? So they're all chopped up. So the next thing we're gonna do is try to get the color out of them. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna grab a big old pot, and into our pot, we're gonna put this bag. This is called a paint bag. So here, do you wanna help me? Do you wanna help? Okay. So it goes over the rim. Oh, before we put them in, we gotta put over the rim though. Okay. You got it? So as you can see, it fits in, and then we're gonna put all the dandelions in here. We're gonna add our water, heat it up, and then we can pull the bag out with all the dandelions, and it's all set to give us color. Very exciting. Okay, do you wanna help me put the dandelions into the pot?
Raining.
Okay. you ready, Maya? You want to see? Yeah, you can get in there. I think. What color do you think it's going to give us?
Yellow.
You think it's going to give us yellow? I think that's a good bet. So we're going to fill it up about to there, about 3/4 full, okay? So in a second, we're going to be lifting the pot up and putting it on the stove to simmer. And this is a good time to mention, you only want to simmer. You don't want to boil. Boiling your material can lead to losing all of your dye. So just do it to a simmer. I usually do about 80 degrees Celsius. So dyeing with kids is just like cooking with kids, and just be careful around heat sources. I would hate for anyone to get hurt from this video. How's it looking? Today we're going to be dyeing wool yarn. These three skeins were mordanted with a 6% solution of ferrous sulfate or iron, and that is going to allow us to have a darker color. And the other yarn we're going to use is white, and that was mordanted with 16% alum or aluminum potassium sulfate. And alum allows the yarn to take up the color of the dye vat itself, which is great. Okay, so we're gonna take a look here. So it's still pretty yellow, hey? So what we're gonna do, are you ready? We're gonna pull this off. Wanna help me? Okay, I'm just gonna grab this. It's a little bit hot, so I'll do this part.
Boiling. Wow, stinky.
Is it stinky? What does it smell like? It smells wet. Okay, just a second. Okay, Maya, you ready? We're gonna add our yarn. We're gonna add this white yarn. It's been mordant with alum and this with iron. You gonna help me put it in? It's okay. Okay, we've got some alum mordanted yarn that can go in. Yeah. It's okay. Yep, put it in. I'm gonna put two of those and two of the iron. Okay. One, two. Okay, and we're gonna heat that for an hour, okay?
Yeah.
You want to give a little stir? You can give a little stir if you want. Okay, should we have a look? Okay, pull it up. Oh, what color is it going?
Lello.
Is it going lello? Okay, oh my goodness. Okay, let's put it back. We still have some time left. Okay, Maya, should we have a look? Okay. Okay, you can grab a spoon. What colors did we get?
Yellow, gorgeous.
Oh my goodness, what a beautiful color. And then what other colors did we get?
Brown.
Do you wanna help me rinse them? Okay, Maya, go for it, give it a good rinse. Mm-hmm. Do you want to help me?
Okay.
Okay.
The duck is kind of
big, though. Okay. What's your favorite part?
Collecting.
Collecting? Should we do more?
Yeah.
Oh, that was good. Results-wise, the alum mordanted yarn came out quite sort of halfway between a lemon and a buttery yellow, I would say. And then the iron came out kind of a slate brown. So those were the two colors that we got, and it was really fun, and I can't wait to do more dyeing with Maya. Okay, you ready, Maya?